Hello and welcome back. Now we're going to be dealing with something new. We're going to be dealing with the difference between two types of Hamza. Hamza is written like this, as you learned. Now we have two types of Hamza. Hamzatul Qata, this is how it is written. Hamzatul Qata, basically, which is this one, is the Hamza that is part of a word. Let's take, for instance, Ahmed. Ahmed is a name of a male in Arabic, is Ahmed. Ahmed. Ahmed, because here, this Hamza is part of the word. We use Hamza in its original form, like this. Hamza. Ahmed. And don't worry about the alif, I will tell you something about it. So the letter here is Hamza. Hamza here makes the sound of A because it has fatha, so Ahmed. Because this Hamza is part of the word, it is written in its original form in this way. Let's take another example. Akhun. Akhun means a brother. Akhun. Akhun, because the Hamza here is part of the word, Akhun, it is written in its original form and it is carried by Alif. Now, Ummun. Ummun. Ummun means mother. Hamza also here is part of the word, that's why it's written in that way. Ihsan. Ihsan means charity. Ihsan means charity. And that's why you see Hamza is in its original form because it's part of the word. And it is pulled by Alif. Basically, it's accompanied with Alif. Because as we said before, Hamza needs Alif or other letter to be accompanied with. So Alif here, because Hamza is at the beginning of words, it comes with Alif, accompanied with Alif. We learned this before. Now, the second type of Hamza is what we call Hamzatul Wasl, linking Hamza. What does it mean? It means the Hamza is not part of the word, but we use it just to make the reading of that word possible. I give you an example. Al, which means the. Al, let's take for instance, Al-Hayatu means life. Al-Hayatu. Al here means the. What makes the here to be more specific? It's l, it's the lam, not a. It's only lam. Many people don't know this. Many people don't know that actually what makes the is the lam of l, not a with it. But why do we use a? Because lam, if, as you see, has sukoon. It has no vowel. In Arabic, you cannot start with non-vowel letter. You can't start with a letter which has no vowel. You can't, English you can, brain and so on. You can have no vowel at the beginning. But in Arabic you have to have a vowel which is fatha or dhamma or kasra. It has to be a, o, or e sound. Like ba, ta, ro, bu and so on. E, t, khi and so on. So because lam has sukoon, which means has no vowel, and we can't start with a letter without a vowel, we adopted the Hamza. It's called Hamzatul Wasl, linking letter, linking Hamza, because we need that Hamza temporary and give it a vowel, which is A, to make the lam readable. So we can read the lam with sukoon. So we say L instead of saying L, it's heavy. You can't say L, you can't start with sukoon. Basically, you can't start without vowel. So we adopted the Hamza here to make the lam readable. So we say al, al baytu, al al hayatu, al kitabu, the book, al baytu, the house, al ghurfatu, the room, al jihazu, the machine, and so on. So a here is adopted just to make the lam, the next lam, which is part of the word, which makes the meaning of the in English, to make it readable because it has sukoon. So here, that Hamza is called Hamzatul Wasl. That's why you don't see the original Hamza the way how we learned before, which is like that curve things. So don't confuse these two. Though you don't see the Hamza, it is there. It's called Hamzatul Wasl, linking Hamza. Okay, now I'm gonna remind you with something I said before, I'm gonna mention it. I said to you when we were learning the letters, I said to you what makes the sound of A or E is Hamza, not Alif. Many people think Alif makes the sound of A or E. Alif has no sound. Alif has only two functions. We use Alif for two functions. He has two functions. Number one, to carry Hamza like this. Here in Al and in Ummun and in all these examples that we have taken. Also, the second function of Alif is to indicate the lengthening of Fatha. And we learned this previously. So, to make Ba, you need that Alif. To make Ta, so we bring Alif to indicate that that Fatha is prolonged in this word. So that is the two functions of Alif. To carry Hamza, or pull it if Hamza has Kasra. Also, to indicate that Fatha here in this word is prolonged and lengthened. Okay, so that's all what I wanted to share within this short lesson. So please go back to the PDF file and do the exercise that I have prepared for you in order to grasp what we have been learning. So I see you then, and thanks for watching.